front to the back, put your hands up like this. From the front to the back, put your hands up, come on, it's fine, huh? Now you make an O with your fist, like this. Are you ready? Come here with me like this, come on. Come on, let's sing. Can you clap together like this? From the front to the back. jump. Don't be afraid to sing. Don't be afraid to clap your hands. Come on, move on, do it together. You make some noise. You sing Jesus. I got a feeling.
in. Take a deep breath out. Come on. Oh, it feels so good to praise our God, amen. Let's go into this time of worship. Let's just remember that our Lord Jesus chose us in all our brokenness, all our inadequacies. He chose us. He chose to mend us, heal us. Even now, He's making that choice to love us and to hold us. Make this moment important. Make this moment intimate with you and Him right now.
You.
How great is your grace, and how new.
specific group of people, and you don't have to look up. You just close your eyes and you can raise your hands and do what you're doing now. But I want to speak to the people who you feel that in your heart, there's a part of you that you haven't let out of this camp yet. There's a part of you that's shut off, the part of you that's closed off. You haven't let it out to your friends, especially if you're a guy, but you're still a tough guy right now. Maybe this whole camp you've been standing there and be like, oh yeah, okay lah, just camp lah. But you know right now, as we sing this next song, I think I just want to remind you that 2,000 years ago, love came down to die for our sins. But I think what's more crucial today is that right now, the same love that created the universe, and the same love that gave you free will, the same love that gives you all the good things in this world, the same love is here right now, and he wants to meet you face to face. So won't you say yes to him? That part of you that you tried to cover up, won't you let him in? Because he's knocking right now, and you gotta let him in. So just with your eyes closed, can you just put your hand on your heart? Just every single person. Just put your hand in your heart. And you don't have to say it out loud, but can you just internally say, Jesus, come in right now. Jesus, come into my heart. Come into my life. Come into the places that I've hid from you and from my friends and from my family. Come and sing. When my heart is overwhelmed and I cannot hear your voice, I hold on to what is true. I cannot see. In the storms, in the storms of life may come, and the road ahead gets steep, I will lift these hands in faith. I will believe. I remind myself of all that you've done.
Won't you sing it out?
And the life I had because of your son.
Love came down.
Love came down and rescued me. Love came down and set me free. I am yours. I am forever yours. The mountains high or valley low, I sing out and remind my soul. I am yours. I am forever yours.
I sing love came down. everything not just from you to him right now.
Mountains high or valley low, I sing out in my soul, I am yours. Love came down and rescued me.
Places. He didn't remain in the heavens. He came down. He came down to the places where we were low, where we were broken, where we had nothing, and he came down to us. Love came down to us today, Arrow. We're not distant from him. We're not far away. He doesn't shun our brokenness, but he comes down close. He draws close. You know, I was just asking the Lord for a word for us tonight, and I was just reminded of broken dreams. You know, we're talking about dreams here at camp. We're talking about God's dream for us, the grandeur, the greatness, the love. But maybe you came in with broken dreams. You came into this camp with dreams which have been crushed. And it just reminds me of a young Joseph. A Joseph who was given great dreams when he was young by the Lord. Whom the Lord told him, whom the Lord showed him that he's going to be in high places, exalted, in high positions. But you know, along the way, his dream got crushed. His dream got discarded. His dream was thrown away in a pit. And maybe that's you today. Maybe you feel like you've come in and your dreams have been crushed. It might have been you didn't get a uni placement you wanted. Maybe if you didn't get the army posting you wanted. Maybe your grades aren't making it. Maybe your family's falling apart. And you feel like these dreams no longer have a hope. That these dreams have been broken. But you know, thank God that his story doesn't end there. Fast forward many years and we see that Joseph is living out the promises of the Lord's dream in his life. He's living as the governor. He's ruling over people with wisdom, with authority, with grace, with love. But you know, more than that, right? The Lord's restoration to him was and his sons. He had two sons. His sons' names were Manasseh and Ephraim. And there's such a beautiful meaning hidden there. Manasseh means to forget. Why? Because the Lord has caused him to forget his troubles. The Lord has caused him to forget his pain, his sorrows. And Ephraim, it means double fruitfulness. Hey, Arrow, today, your story does not end in brokenness. Your story does not end in crushed dreams. You might have come in with broken dreams, crushed dreams, feeling lost, feeling forlorn, feeling hopeless. But your story is not going to end there. Your story is going to be one where you receive double fruitfulness, where you receive a double portion upon your life, where your dreams are going to be revived and you're going to receive that double fruitfulness and all of that. Will begin because you have forgotten your sorrow in this camp right here because love came down. The only reason your dream can be revived today, the only reason your crushed dream can come alive is because there was the heavenly Joseph who was crushed for you, for your dream to come alive. And right now he's just breathing out a revival upon your dream. He's breathing out a revival upon your dream. Will you raise your hands? Will you raise your hands and receive the love that came down? The heavenly Joseph who came close. We'll be right back.
Father, I just thank you that our portion here tonight is not brokenness. Our portion here tonight are not crushed dreams. Our portion here tonight is the double fruitfulness. That our portion tonight will not remain in sorrow and in pain, but we will forget it because you are good to us, Lord. You are a good Father. You are a good, good Father. And Lord, I just thank you that as we lift up these broken dreams, these crushed dreams into your hands, that we will see them come alive in your hands. We will see hope arise. And I thank you, Lord, that these dreams have nothing to do with what we can or cannot do, but all to do with what you will do through us, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray, and all of Arrow says, amen. Come on, let's just give him the praise. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Woo! That was amazing. The presence is amazing. So you know what, right now, we're just gonna break for toilet time, because we know you guys need to use the toilet. So if you guys need to go to the toilet, please be back. Don't linger outside. Come back in as soon as possible. Girls, as you guys go to the toilet, guys, you know, you guys are the men of the house. Yeah, men of the house. So can you guys help to grab the chairs and lay it out so that, you know, when we come back in and receive the word, we're comfortable on the chairs as well. Thanks, guys.
I'm not sure what the you know it's so sad, lor. What are you talking about?
We were gonna play like sad.
What is it? But it's never solid, sir. Ah, they need more songs like this. They have that moment, they put it in. Wow, they do that, sir. They have their own instrumental, but I feel like in the song, songs, I love the Homeboy album, but I feel like if they had a song that had that,
I'm gonna take a picture of this. Thank you.
People listen to this, wherever you find yourself today, I don't care if you find yourself in the mountaintop or the valley low, God is there with you. This has been spoken many, many times over in this camp, but you cannot go without having this realization and this revelation in your heart that no matter where you are, in your darkest valley, He is there. In the highest mountaintop, He is there. His promise is this: I will never leave you. I will never forsake you. You can never forget that. You feel His presence here today. You go back home, you will still feel His presence. His presence will never leave you. That is His promise. Believe that. Believe that. Believe that. Arrow Ministry, we are not a ministry who just do things for hype. We're not a ministry who just do things for self. We're not a ministry that is strong in our own mind. But we are strong in His presence. We are strong in His love. We are only strong because He is with us. We are only favored because He is with us. Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Would you just lift up the highest shout of praise to Jesus, your Lord, your lover. Just shout it out to Him. Shout His name. Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Because of you, we have
That was sick, man.
Speaks to you. You feel weak. You feel useless. You feel that you won't amount to anything much, that you are nothing. And words like that have been spoken over you. If you feel like a failure because someone has declared you to be a failure. If you feel like a failure because you have failed in in a certain area in your life, or you keep failing in your exams, or you keep failing in something that you feel causes you to have this identity. The presence of God is in this place to bind every wound, to heal the brokenhearted, to set you free from that prison of fear, that prison of doubt, that prison of confusion, that prison of low self-esteem, that prison that you find yourself trapped in. The presence of God is here to set you free. And when the Son of God sets you free, child of God, you are free indeed. So right now, as the leaders come forward, do not be embarrassed, do not be shy, do not worry about what others think about you, that if you step forward, you're showing a sign of weakness. Hey, when you are weak, the Lord Himself will be your strength. When you humble yourself, His grace flows and overflows in your life, because the Bible declares, God resists the proud, but He gives grace to the humble. So if you take that step of faith to humble yourselves before Him, even so what if others think you are weak? The Word of God declares that when you are weak, only then you shall be strong, because He Himself will be your strength. So everyone, you must come forward, go to a leader, let the leaders lay hands on you, anoint you with oil, and let them declare into your life, speak into your life, declare words in season, words of life, words that bring forth healing, words that bring forth freedom, words that bring forth deliverance into your life, and receive it. Receive it. Receive it. So when you step forward, do not be in a mode of praying. Just lift up your hands and be in a mode of receiving. And allow these anointed and precious leaders that God has raised, these anointed and precious shepherds that God has raised in this house, to speak forth those words into your life. They shall be like a seed that is sown into your heart, into your mind. And when that seed germinates, when that seed blossoms, it will spring forth and bring forth the good fruit of the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come forward, youths. Worship Him. Hallelujah.
place.